Hello, my name is Nitin. We have upgraded the C-DASY6 specific absorption rate system in our laboratory
to version 6.10,
the latest release from SAR. The release comes with three major features. One, 100 new UIDs for 5G FR1 have been added to the communication system database. Two, the SAR evaluation as specified in the unified standard has been extended to 10 GHz. And third, the epithelial power density or transmitted power density averaged over 1 cm square and 4 cm square can be assessed. This last point is very important because the IEEE C95-2019 standard and the ICNIRP guidelines define new safety limits in terms of the transmitted power above 6 GHz. Today, I will demonstrate how straightforward SAR and transmitted power density measurements above 6 GHz can be done. For this, I use the 7 GHz system verification dipole that is delivered by SAR together with the calibration certificate that not only includes the calibrated 1 gram and 10 gram values but also the 1 cm square and 4 cm square transmitted power density values. The HBBL broadband liquid used for SAR measurements in the sub 6 GHz bands also works for the 6 to 10 GHz band and is used for this demo. The measurements will be made in the flat section of the SAM Phantom.
To begin, I position the 7 GHz dipole beneath the flat section of the SAM Phantom and adjust the signal generator power so that the forward power delivered to the antenna is plus 14 dBm, that is 25 milliwatt. We are now ready to set up the measurement in the DASY6 software. First, I import the dipole calibration files which are delivered with the calibration certificates into the inventory. Next, I click the system check tab and add the 7 GHz dipole HSL measurements to the project. The measurements are automatically added to the project with default area and zoom scan grid settings, which are in line with the current standards. I now move to the measurement tab and enable the 7 GHz measurement. The measurement consists of a fast area scan as well as an area scan and a check scan. The check scan is a regular zoom scan followed by a rotation job which measures probe isotropy at the peak location. I press play to start the measurement and enter plus 14 dBm for the input power to the dipole. I accelerate the video. The measurements are now finished. The measured 1 gram and 10 gram SAR values are 6.81 watt per kg and 1.19 watt per kg. The software automatically compares the measured 1 gram and 10 gram SAR values with the calibrated values from the dipole calibration files imported into the inventory earlier and computes the deviation. In the current measurement, the deviation is minus 2.6% for 1 gram and minus 0.5% for 10 gram. The isotropic deviation is minus 0.4%. These values are well within the standard requirements. To get detailed measurement results, I click on the zoom scan. The measurement properties show the transmitted power density values for 1 cm square and 4 cm square averaging area, which are 68.1 watt per meter square and 29.7 watt per meter square respectively. These values compare well with the calibrated values and the deviation are less than minus 2.6%. The system check results are available in tabular form for export into Excel. It is also possible to generate reports with plots for individual measurements using the word report option here. The word report includes all details such as the probe or DAE, scan settings, HSL values, and also the measured SAR or power density values and their deviations from targets. The new DASY6 6.10 release is another important extension in view of the fast emerging 5G. It adds 100 new UIDs for 5G FR1 to the communication system database. It extends the SAR evaluation to 10 GHz as specified in the unified standard, and it is the first system that can assess the transmitted power density to assess the safety limits as defined in the IEEE C95-2019 standard and the ICNIRP guidelines above 6 GHz. Thank you for watching this video.